Double English is also a type of linked list that is bidirectional. That is bidirectional. It means that we can traverse this type of linked list, double linked list, in both the directions. We can go from head node to the last node. It means we are going into the forward direction. We can move into the forward direction as well as we can traverse it into the backward direction, where we go from last node to the first node. Each element inside the linked list is called a node. Each element inside the linked list is called a node. And remember this thing, every node in doubly linked list consists of three parts. It consists of three parts. First part, if you see into this diagram, first part is the previous pointer. Previous pointer which stores the address of the previous node. Second part of the node is called data part, or it is also called as information part of a node, which stores the information of the node. Whereas the third part, if you see in this diagram, is the next pointer, which stores the address of the next node to which this node is connected. It means that in doubly linked list, every node has the information of previous node as well as the next node inside it. Both the information of the nodes, previous node and next node, is available at the node of a doubly linked list. And what are different operations we can perform on doubly linked list? We can do all the operations that we have seen on single linked list can also be performed on a doubly linked list. The operations are insertion of a new node in the linked list. Again, there are three possibilities. In insertion, we can add a new node at the beginning, we can add a new node at the end of the linked list, or we can add a new node after a given node. Then another operation is called as delete operation. We can perform deletion of a node from the linked list. Again, there are three possibilities of deletion. The node that you are deleting may be a first node, or that node may be available inside the linked list, or the node that you are deleting may be available at the end of the linked list. It means that it is a delete first option operation, delete last operation, or delete key operation. So we can see this implementation of this in delete function. Then we have third operation called as display. Here there are two possibilities in display operation. We can display a doubly linked list in forward direction as well as in backward direction. Then the next operation that we can perform on doubly linked list is searching. We can also search any element inside a linked list. Then the last operation that we are going to perform on this doubly linked list is sorting. We can sort the elements of the doubly linked list in ascending order, or it may be in descending order, according to the need of a programmer. We can sort it. Any doubt, students, till this point? Please write in the chat box. Have you understood the definition of doubly linked list, the node structure into the doubly linked list? What are different parts in the node of a doubly linked list? Please write in the chat box so that I will come to know, and then we'll move to the next point. If you have any questions, I'll answer your questions. Okay, that means you understood your writing. Yes, means you have understood. So now we'll see how to represent a doubly linked list, how it looks like. A doubly linked list is considered as a chain of nodes which are connected by two pointers. Here every node is connected by two pointers. So one is called previous pointer and another is called as next pointer. next pointer is connected to the next node, immediate next node, whereas previous pointer is connected to the immediate previous node inside of the linked list. If you see this diagram, here there is again a special node pointer called as start pointer, which always points to the first node inside the linked list. The first node is connected to the next node with the help of next pointer. Here, if you see, it is connected, 10 is connected to 20 with the help of this next pointer. 20 is connected to 30 with the help of next pointer. Then towards right of 30, there is no further nodes into this linked list. That's why the next pointer of node 30 is null. Now, similarly, if you go back from 30 to 20, it is connected with the help of the previous pointer. So the previous part of 30 consists of the address of node 20, whereas the previous part of node 20 consists of the address of node 10, whereas node 10 does not have any previous node to it. That's why the previous part of node 10 is null. So if you notice here, there are two null values present in the first node and in the last node. First node, previous part is always null in double linked list. First node, previous part is always null. Whereas the last node, next part is always null in double linked list. Then the question comes, how do you identify the first node and the last node in the linked list? So you can answer to this question. First question is, how do you identify the first node in the doubly linked list? How do you identify first node in doubly linked list? Write your answer in the chat box. Student, how do you identify the first node in the linked list? Write your answer in the chat room. My question is, how do you identify the first node in the linked list, doubly linked list? So the first question answer is given by Shreya Bijam. Previous is null. Okay. Then Bijal Bhardwa. Previous is null. Okay. Rishikesh Kulkarni is saying both the ends are null. No, it is not. Shreya Bijam is saying, and start pointer points to the first node. Good. There are two possibilities to identify the first node in the linked list. It can be identified by the start pointer. Start pointer always shows the address of the first node. If you see in the diagram, start pointer is always at the beginning. It never move. It always points, or it is always pointing to the first node in the linked list. Then another way we can identify is a node whose previous part is null. A node whose previous part is null is also called the first node in the doubly linked list. Then the second question to you is, how do you identify the last node in the linked list, doubly linked list? How do you identify the last node in doubly linked list? Write your answer in the chat box. Okay. I got the first answer from Shreya, then Ashwin, then Tushar, Sachid, Vijal, Atharva, Kalpesh. All are right. Answer given by the students is right. Srivas Padil is also right. Here, a node whose next part is null. Any node inside the linked list whose next part is null is called the last node in doubly linked list. See this diagram? Here, node 30, if you see its next part, it is null. And the next part null means it tells the compiler that it is the end of the linked list. Your linked list terminates here. Now, if you see carefully this diagram, in the above linked list, every node's store the information of the previous node as well as the next node. It is two-way connected. Every node is two-way connected in forward direction as well as in backward direction. In forward direction, it is connected by the next pointer. In backward direction, it is connected by the previous pointer. If you see here, node 10 is the first node of the linked list because it is pointed by the start pointer as well as its previous part is null. Whereas node 30 in the above diagram is the last node because its next part is null. Now you see node 20 has the information of its previous node, that is node 10, as well as it has the information of its next node, that is node 30. Every node inside the doubly linked list has the information of previous node as well as the next node. Now we'll see the first operation on doubly linked list is insertion operation. In insertion operation, it can be performed in three different ways. We can insert a new node at the beginning of the linked list. We can insert a new node at the end of the linked list. Then we can insert a new node after a particular node or at a specific location inside the linked list. Now let's see the algorithm for inserting a new node at the beginning of the linked list. We have already studied how to insert a new node at the beginning of the linked list in singly linked list. So we are going to use the same logic here also, but we need to do one extra connection in terms of insertion of a node in the doubly linked list. We need to connect two pointers. One is called previous as well as next. That has to be taken in doubly linked list. We can use the following steps. We can use the following step to insert a new node at the beginning of the doubly linked list. Step one, create a new node with a given value and then assign new node of previous as null. New node previous as null, because whenever you want to make any new node as the first node, the previous part of the first node is always null. Right? So that's why immediately you have to assign, after creation of a new node, you immediately have to assign new node's previous part as null. Second step, we check whether the list is empty or not. Before inserting any elements inside the linked list, always check the empty condition. If it is empty, then assign null to the new node's next part also, because this is the only node available into the linked list. And new node as start. It means we are making that only available node as the start node. This will be true only when the linked list is empty. If linked list is empty, we'll immediately assign new node's next part to null, and then we make new node as the start node. Then the next case is, if linked list is not empty, then what to do? If the linked list is not empty, then assign start to the new node next part and then new node to start. To understand this, we'll consider this diagram. And I want to insert, say, node 40 at the beginning of this linked list. Our linked list consists of the elements 10, 20 and 30. Here 10 is the first node in this linked list. Then with the help of that p equal to malloc size of struct node line, we can create this node. Then we fill the information part by p of info equal to the number. Assume that the number entered by the user is 40. A new node has been created. With previous pointer, immediately we assign previous pointer to null because we want to make this node as the first node into the linked list. Now just imagine, if I put this node at the beginning of the linked list, what adjustment I have to do? I need to make this pointer start to point to the first node, that is now 40. Then the next part of the node 40 should store the address of node 10. Node 10's previous part must store the address of node 40. It means node 10 should be two-way connected to node 40. In previous part of node 10 is node 40, whereas next part of node 40 is node 10. See this? After successfully inserting node 40 in the diagram, there are two connections here. One goes from node 40 to node 10. We are storing start of next into start of next of previous equal to P and P of next equal to start. After that, start equal to P. So three lines are needed to attach this node 40 inside the linked list. We'll see the code in the program. It means when you put this node 40 at the beginning, we need to do three lines of code. First, you connect node 10 to node 40 by the previous pointer of node 10. How do you access node 10's previous part? You see in the above diagram, it can be accessed by the line start of next. Start of next is node 10. Start of previous equal to node P, and P of next equal to start. And at last one line we need to add, that is start equal to P equal to start. So that becomes the starting node inside the linked list. The another case is I want to add a new node at the end of the linked list. How to add a new node at the end of the list? Again, we are going to use the same logic that we have applied in the insertion of a new node at the end of the singly linked list. But again, we need to take care here in doubly linked list, connection of both the sides, forward direction as well as backward direction. We need to take care of double pointers here. How to add a new node at the end of the linked list? Step one, we create a new node with a given value, and then immediately we assign new node's next part as null. Why it is assigned to null? Because we want to make this new node as the last node. And as we know, the last node next part is always null. We create a new node with a given value and immediately we assign new node's next part as null. Then in the next step, we check is start equal to null. It means if the linked list is empty, then the coming node, the newly created node, will be the only node available inside the linked list. Then check if it is empty. If the linked list is empty, then assign null to the nodes, new nodes previous part also. So the new node next part is also null. New nodes previous part is also null. It means that this is the only node available inside the linked list. And then write one more line where you are assigning new node to start. Step number three will be executed only when the linked list is empty. Now, the another case of it is, if the linked list is not empty, then what to do? We'll go to step number four. If the linked list is not empty, then we define a node pointer temp, or you can give any name to this temporary pointer. We use pointer Q for traversing purpose. So here we have defined a temp pointer, which is going to help us to go to the last node from the beginning. Then initialize this newly created pointer, temporary pointer, to start. Write a code for searching a last node. So in step 5, keep moving the temporary pointer to its next node until you reach the last node in the linked list. Now, how do you get the last node? Whenever temp of next pointer is equals to null, when it reaches to null, we can say that we have obtained the last node in the doubly linked list. Once you got the last node in the doubly linked list, you need to write two lines of code. One more thing that you have to do is you have to write two lines of code. We assign new node to temp of next. It means the address of the new node is now stored into temp of next last node. Next part is now storing the address of new node. After that, temp equal to new node of previous part. So the node that we have created, its previous part must store the last node information. So that's why this line is there. That is temp equal to new node of previous. To understand the last line, we'll consider this diagram. There is a linked list having three elements 10, 20, 30. The start pointer is pointing to node 10. It means that node 10 is the first node into the linked list. Now we'll create a new node, that is P, whose value is 40. And after creation of the new node, we immediately assign the next pointer to null because we want to make this new node as the last node inside this linked list. So before inserting node P at the end of the linked list, this will be the picture. Just imagine I will pick this node 40 and I will put it at the end of the linked list. Then what connections, what lines of code is needed, what adjustment I have to do to attach node 40 at the end of the linked list. For that, I will take the help of one another pointer, that is pointer temp or pointer q, which will go on searching the last element from the first node to the last node. There we are going to apply a search last node algorithm. At the end of the particular search, you'll find node q is pointing to node 30. Pointer q points to node 30. So this will be a picture after the insertion of node 40. See, node 30 is say pointer q, is pointed by pointer q, and I want to attach this to the node p. So I have to write the line, that is assign new node to temp of next. So here we use the pointer name as temp instead of q. So assume that this 30, node 30 is pointed by temporary pointer. The first line that we are going to write is temp of next equal to p. Temp of next equal to p is our new node, right? So forward link has been created from last node to the node 40. So in the forward direction, it is now connected. Now if you see, previously the next part of node 30 was null. Now it is updated and it is now storing the address of node 40. That is node P, right? Forward direction, node 30 is connected to node 40. Now I want to connect node P, that is node 40, to node 30. So how to do that? Just write P of previous, that is new node of previous pointer should point to the node 30 whose name is now temp, correct? That's why you see here temp, we are pointing temp to new node of previous. By this line, there will be a new link created from node P to node 30 in the backward direction. After successfully doing this, you'll find the next diagram. In the next diagram, you see there will be a new link from node 30 to node P, whereas there is a previous pointer which points from node P to node 30, right? So what we have done into this insertion of a new node at the end of the linked list, we have taken the help of one pointer, that is called temporary pointer. Initially we made that pointer points to the start of the linked list. Then we traverse the linked list till we reach the end of the linked list. So we apply a searching algorithm there and assume that we found the last node in the linked list. The node is 30. So that after that searching algorithm, searching function, the temporary pointer is now pointing to node 30 here. To attach the new node, 40 at the end of the linked list, we have to first make the forward correction from node temp to node p. So how do that? We write temp of next. Temp of next here, it should store the address of node new node p. So we write assign temp of next to new node. So temp of next equal to p, and then p of previous equal to temp to create a backward connection where the previous part of node p is now connected to node 30. That is the temporary node now. By this, we have connected node 30 and 40 in both the directions, forward direction as in backward direction. And after that, we will find a new diagram where there are four nodes now. First node is 10, next node is 20, next node is 30, and last node is 40 in the linked list. So we have completed two algorithms: how to insert a new node at the beginning of the linked list, then how to insert a new node at the end of the linked list. Till this point, any questions, students? Please ask your question in the chat box, or you can unmute your mic and you can ask me the question. I will go back to the first algorithm where we have studied how to insert a new node at the beginning. If you have any question in the first algorithm, you can ask me. Here, this is the first diagram in the first algorithm where we studied how to insert a new node at the beginning. Any questions, student, here in this algorithm, please write in the chat box immediately. Rushikesh is asking some another question. Is third module is also in UT? Yes, it is there. First three modules will be going to come in your exam. The portion which covers from module number 3, we are going to ask the question from that module also. Any questions in the first part of the algorithm where we studied how to insert a new node at the beginning of the linked list? I will take your questions quickly. Any doubt in this insertion of a new node at the beginning, students? Please reply. I want to answer from all the students whether you understood this concept of inserting a new node at the beginning of the linked list. Okay. You people are saying no doubt. Very good. So I'll ask you some question now on this two algorithms. My first question to you on the first algorithm where we studied how to insert a new node at the beginning of the linked list. Okay, how do you create a new node in this algorithm? What is the line we use to create a new node in doubly linked list? The first question is how to create a new node. We use the line p equal to malloc size struct node in singly linked list. Here also we are going to use the same line because that is a dynamic memory allocation function which automatically allocates the memory required for a node. No matter how many pointers are there, how many fields are there into the node, the line will be same, p equal to malloc size of struct node. Now the next question, second question, listen carefully. The second question is, a node in doubly linked list consists of how many parts? How many parts are there in a node of a doubly linked list? Somebody has written 2. others also reply, your answer will be recorded. A road in double linked list consists of how many parts? I got many answer from many students. That answer is 3. Sachit is saying previous, content, and next. Okay, good. Who has written 2? Somebody has written 2 fills. Janvi said there are 2 parts. Our answer is wrong. Others are true. Yes, there are 3 parts in every. Okay, Janvi is saying it is by mistake. Okay, so you understood there are 3 parts, right? So there are 3 parts. First is the previous pointer, which shows the previous node of that particular node. Then information part, data part, or you can say content of the node, which shows the value of a node. Third part is called as next pointer, which shows the address of the next node. The node in the doubly linked list has the information of both the nodes, previous node as well as next node. Is this statement is true or false? I repeat, the node inside the doubly linked list consists of the information of both the nodes, the previous node as well as the next node. Is this statement is true or false? Write your answer. I want the answer from all the students. Okay, the statement is true. Then the next question is, how do you identify the last node in the doubly linked list? Write the answer. How do you identify the last node in the doubly linked list? Right, a node whose next part is null is the last node. Okay, write us 3-4 line of code which will search the last node in the linked list. Write a code, C programming code, which search the last node in the linked list. Which search the last node in the linked list. We have studied this searching algorithm in the implementation of single linked list also. So I want you people to write the similar type of code which is going to search the last node in the linked list. Take 1 minute and write a code to find the last node in the linked list. I got the first answer from Tushar. Tushar Amotskar. He has written a while loop. Then there is a condition. We check that is P of x not equal to null. If this condition is true, he is moving the pointer P to the next location. But initially, Tushar, where is P pointer pointing to? Sriya has written a modified answer. Very good. Very good, Tushar. Initially, the pointer P or the pointer that you are using for traversing must point to the starting node inside the double linked list. Other students reply soon. Okay, the next question now. How do you check whether the linked list is empty or not? How do you check whether the doubly linked list is empty or not? Write your answer in the chat box. How do you check whether the linked list is empty or not? Should some answers. First is from Shreyas, then Sachet, Bijal, Ruchita, Rutuja, Rutuja, Atharva, Kamli, Sneha, then Kalpesh, Vishwakarma. Kalpesh, the question is how to check whether the linked list is empty or not. So this is not the answer. Whenever start pointer points to null, when start is null, we can say that linked list is empty. Now my next question to all of you is, how many elements we can insert in doubly linked list? How many elements we can insert in doubly linked list? Good. So the answer issued is we can insert unlimited elements. There is no size limit in linked list implementation. That's why if the size is not fixed, we can insert n number of elements as per our need in the doubly linked list. Now I will quickly revise both the algorithms. Before that, I want to ask you how to add a new node at the beginning. Write a code for it. If consider this diagram and add a new node at the beginning. Just write 2-3 lines of code which will add node P at the beginning of the linked list. you have to do two connections, then you have to make node P as the start node in the linked list. Write a code, two, three lines of code, which will connect node P at the beginning of the linked list. First thing in this algorithm you have to do is, you have to store the address of the start node into the next part of a node here. How do you store it? P of nest equal to start. Then there must be a connection from start node to the new node. Then how do you store, make this connection? Start of previous equal to P. And at last you want to make node P, new node, as the start node. Then move the start pointer from previous conditions to the new node by writing a line start equal to P. Write three lines of code which will attach node P at the beginning of the linked list. Write your answer in the chat box. Add new node at the beginning of the linked list. You can use this diagram for writing code. Let's see who answers the question first. Adding a new node P at the beginning of the linked list. Write your answer in the chat box, students. I got the first answer to this question from Shreya Bijam. So she has written three lines of code. First thing that she is doing is, she wants to store the address of start pointer into P of next, P of previous equal to none, and start equal to P. Shreya, one more line that you forgot is to make the node 10, that is the start node, to point to the node P. You can write start of previous equal to P. Start of previous equal to P. We have already created, we already assigned P of previous to null when we created that node. Okay, you modified your answer now. P of next equal to start, P of previous equal to null, okay. Start of previous equal to P. And start equal to P. Okay. Now Tushar has given some other code. Create a new node, then new node data part will be filled with the value. New node next is null, new node previous is null. If L of start equal to null, then L of start equal to new node. Okay. Otherwise, new node next should store the address of L of start, okay. L of start of previous equal to new node. L of start equal to new node. So, sir, have you written this code on your own or have you copied it from the internet? The code is correct. Any other student wants to add? Okay. Not copied, but I have notes. Good. I want you to write the code on your own. Any other student wants to add to this question, student? Okay. Sachet is writing something. Write your answer, students. You can use this diagram. Just see this diagram and imagine and write a code for it. First, I'll give a hint to you. Create a forward link from node P to node 10. write a line for that. After that, create in the second step, create a new link from node 10 to node 40 in the backward direction. For that, you need to take the help of previous pointer. In first step, we take the help of the next pointer of node P to connect from node 40 to node 10. In the next immediate line, I want to connect node 10 to node 40, so I have to take the help of previous pointer to connect it to node 40. And at last, I want to shift this start pointer, which is pointing to 10, now point to 40. Shift it from 10 to 40. Only three lines of code is needed. Okay, this is the way we can connect now. So there are three lines of code needed to attach node P at the beginning of the linked list. P of next equal to start of previous equal to node P, and at last we write start equal to P. Only three lines of code needed to attach node P at the beginning of the linked list. Now we'll quickly revise the second algorithm, where we attached new node, that is P, at the end of the linked list. So we're going to use this diagram. Just imagine if we put this node 40 at the end of the linked list, what connections I have to do? To identify last node in the linked list, we have taken a temporary pointer which initially pointing to the start node. Then we apply the searching algorithm to find the last node. Assume that you found the last node 30 here. A node whose next part is null is last node. So here we found, and I want to make the connection, forward connection from this last node to the node P. So we'll write temp of next equal to new node, that is P. So this is the line we use. Temp of next will be stored into new node. After that, new node previous part should be connected to last node 30. So P of previous equal to temp. So it is two-way connected now. So this is the code we need to attach the new node at the end of the linked list. So what we have done into this algorithm, first we created the new node. We filled the value data part of the node. After that, we applied the searching algorithm to find the last node inside the linked list. After finding the last node, we have to write two lines of code to attach the last node to new node, that is P, in the forward direction. So we will write temp of next equal to P. In the next immediate line, we'll write P of previous equal to temp. So by these two lines, we can successfully connect no new node created at the end of the linked list. So after inserting the node 40 at the end of the linked list, a new linked list will look like this, where there are four nodes, 10, 20, 30, and 40. Okay, student. So I want to know, have you understood both the algorithms of inserting a new node at the beginning and inserting a new node at the end of the linked list? Write your answer in the chat box. Whether you understood both the algorithms of inserting a new node, write your answer. Okay, I'm getting that you understood, yes. Is how to insert a new node after a given node in the linked list. Now it may happen that we can give a position where you need to insert a new node, or we can ask user to insert a new node after a particular node. So here this function is taking two parameters, the number that you want to insert and the position. In this code, I use the position where you want to insert the new node. C is the position where to insert a new node after a particular node. So we have taken two pointers, help of two pointers. One is P P pointer is used to create a new node, whereas Q pointer we are used to traverse inside the linked list. Then I is the variable we have taken for for loop purpose. Initially, I assign Q equal to start. It means both the pointers at the beginning, and I wanted to move from first node to the exact position where we want to insert. So I will take a for loop by which I can move the Q pointer from first node to the exact position where we want to insert the new node. So by this for loop, you can find the Q pointer is moved to the position where you want to insert that new node. Now see how this for loop have been written here. If I equal to 0, I less than C minus 1, I plus plus. Or you can take I equal to 1, I less than C, I plus plus. One and the same thing, right? But what we are doing here? We are moving, shifting this Q pointer from current location to the location till you reach its exact position. And if you found that in between, if the number of nodes are not sufficient in the linked list, if Q is null before ending this while loop or for loop, then we can print a message that there are less number of elements than the mentioned position, and we exit from this loop. And if this for loop completes successfully, it means that you reach to the exact position where you want to insert a new node. Then immediately after finishing the while loop, you need to create a new node. You have created a new node by this line P equal to malloc size of struct node. This line is standard which we have used for creating a new node. After successfully creating a new node, you have to assign the information part in insert data part into P of info equal to number. Then these four lines of logic is needed to assign a new node into the linked list. To understand these four lines of code, I will take the help of another diagram and we'll write it again. These are the four lines we are going to use to connect node 2 to node P. So I have taken the help of a pointer Q. To understand that four lines of logic, we'll consider this diagram. We have taken Q pointer and say I want to insert node P after position 2. So what is position 2 here? Node 10 is at position 1. Node 20 is at position 2. I want to insert new node P, that is 40, after position 2. It means I want to insert 40 in between 20 and 30. Or in other words, we can say that we want to insert 40 after node 20 in this linked list. Now to get the position 2, I have to traverse node pointer Q from the beginning till the node 20. So at the end of that for loop, if you see in the for loop, the code has been written. At the end of the for loop, you will get node 20, correct? So assume that you found node 20 here. The Q pointer is now shifted from beginning to the exact position where you want to insert after this particular node. So here Q pointer is pointing to node 20. Now both the nodes are available, the node after which you want to insert and a new node also. A node after which you want to insert is pointed by pointer Q. A new node is pointed by pointer P. Right. So the connections that we need to make to put 40 inside 20 and 30. When you do that, you need to connect new node P from both the sides. There will be two links on the right side and two links on the left hand side. It means that node P is forwardly connected to node 30 as well as backwardly connected from node 30 to 40. Similarly, node 40, that is the new node, is connected on the left hand side in the forward direction from 20 to 40. There is a link, and there is one more link which will connect node 40 to node 20 in the backward direction. So it means that what I'm telling is we need to connect node P both the ways. On right hand side there are two links, right? One is next part and another is previous part. Similarly, note 40, if you see on the left hand side, there are again two more links. One is next part q of next to p, and then p of previous equal to q. Always remember that when you want to insert the new node at the big means after a particular node inside the link list, double link list, connect the previous part and then you connect the next part of it. I want to first make the connection from node 30 to node p. How do you do that? How do you refer node 30 here by this line q of next? Correct, q of next is node 30 here. Of that particular node, its previous part. So it is a double pointed concept. Check this line. Q of next is 30, its previous part is now storing a node P, which is the address of node P. You can say node P, right? So there will be a new link, a backward link, which come from node 30's previous part, node P. One link has been successfully created. Another thing is, node 30 is connected in backward direction to node P. I want to now connect node P to node 30 in forward direction. Node P to node 30 in forward direction. Now, if you see here, it means I have done a connection from node 30 to node 40 by using the previous pointer. Correct. Now I want to store address of node 30 into p of next. So here I want to store the address of node 30. How to do that? Just write a line, p of next must store the address of q of next. What is q of next in above diagram? It is 30. So p of next equal to q of next is the next line, this line, by which a new link has been created from p of next to the q of next. See this, p of next is connected to node 30 and node 30 is identified by q of next. It means that on the right side both the links have been successfully created. Only the thing is remained is I need to connect node p on the left hand side to node q. To understand this again, here if you see in this diagram, node p and node p q connections. On the left hand side, if I want to make the connection from node P to node Q, I will use the line P of previous equal to Q. Third line to make the connection, P of previous equal to Q. It's the address of node Q is stored into Q of previous, P of previous, sorry. Address of node Q is stored into P of previous part. Now to make the forward connection from node Q, node P, I will use the next line, this Q of next equal to P. It means that Q of next is now storing the address of node P. After the fourth line, we can say that we have successfully attached node P on the right hand side as well as on the left hand side. After these four lines of code, node P is now successfully inserted after node 20 in this link list. Check this diagram, large diagram. So your new link lists look like this. The first node is 10, second is 20, now third node is 40, and fourth node is having value 30. So this way we can insert a new node after a particular node or after given position. So that we have performed here. Any questions, student, in the third algorithm where we studied how to insert a new node after a given position? Whenever this type of questions are asked in your examination, you have to draw this type of diagram in the rough work, apply the code, check whether it is working or not. If it works fine, you can then write that code into your fair work. Okay. Any questions, any doubt, students, in third algorithm where we studied how to insert a new node after a given position in the double linked list? Please write your answer in the chat box immediately. Have you understood? Very good. I got the answer from Vijal, Vishal, Avi, Ansa. Sachit. Others, please reply. Have you understood how to insert a new node after a given position? This is a very, very important topic, and this type of questions are always asked in your exams. Other students also reply, have you understood how to insert a new node after a given node? Before going to the insertion part, I want to know, do you have any doubts in three algorithms that we have seen? Inserting a new node at the beginning, inserting a new node after a given node, then inserting a new node at the end of the linked list. Do you have any questions, students? Okay, you are saying that you understood. If you understood, I'll ask you a question just to check whether you really understood this algorithm on how to insert a new node after a given position. Now, to understand that, we'll consider this diagram. So my first question to Tushar now. Tushar, assume that the node after which you want to insert is node 20, which is pointed by node Q here. And node P is the new node you want to insert after node 20. You can refer node 20 by a pointer Q. You can refer node 40 by a pointer P. Tell me the first line which will create, which will attach node 30 to node P in the backward direction. How do you connect node 30 to node P in backward direction? It means the previous part of node 30 must store the address of node P. Anyone who knows, write the answer in the chat box. My question is, I want to make a new connection from node 30's previous part to node P. Write a single line of code which will connect node 30's previous part to node P, or node 30's previous part store the address of node P. Shriya has written, very good, Shriya. The first thing is, I must get how to get the address of node 30. You see this diagram, I got two answers from Shriya and Badal Oja. Both are correct. See how it is. We need to apply double pointer concept. To reach node 30, I will refer Q of next. So once I write Q of next, I am at node 30. But its previous, then again I have to apply that pointer. That is Q of next of previous part is equals to P. Perfect. That's fine. So you have created a new link from node 30 to node P. One way it is now connected from node 30 to node 40. In a forward direction, I want to connect now. Second question. I want to connect node P to node 30. How do you connect node P to node 30? Write the next line which will connect P of X to the node 30. Write the second line of code which will going to connect node P to node 30. Yes, quickly. Very good. I got the answer from Rutuja. Perfect. P of previous. No. I want a forward link from, it's wrong. Rutuja, it's wrong. I want to connect in a forward direction. When you connect in the forward direction, you have to refer to next part. P of next equal to Q of next. I think another student have written the answer. Perfect. Khushi Mahajan, then Badal Oja, Rutuja is now correct. Vishal Mishra is correct. Very good. So now we connected node P on the right side. Both the connections have been done. If you see the below diagram, by those two lines, we have successfully connected the node 40 to node 30, both directions, forward and backward direction. Now what is remained is to connect node 40 to the node Q on the left hand side in both the directions. Now my third question to all of you is, I want to connect node P to Q next. Node P should consist of the address of the previous next part of node Q. I want to connect node Q to node P in forward direction. Connect node Q to node P in forward direction. Which code will write? So that there will be a forward link which goes from node Q of next part to the node P. Write the code, students. Connect node Q to node P in forward direction. When I say this forward direction, you have to use next pointer. When I say backward direction, you use previous pointer to connect it. Good. The first answer came from Shreya Bijam. We need to write Q of next equal to P. It means we are storing the address of node P in the next part of Q. Perfect. All are right. All are right. Vishal also, Chetan Kumar, Badal. Everybody is right. Now the last link is remain to be connected from node P. I want to make a new connection from node P to node Q in backward direction. When I say backward direction, you have to refer previous pointer. Write a link which will connect node P to node Q in backward direction. So write the code which will connect node P to node Q in backward direction. Good. Atharva Kamli has written the answer. Badal Oja, Ashwini Kumar. Very good. All of you are correct. All of you are correct. Perfect. Perfect. It means that everybody has how to insert a new node after a given node in the linked list. So you'll expect all the questions till this point in your term test 1.